Yeah, this is the theorem, angle 1 equals to double of angle 2. Again, I am going to repeat. Angle made by an arc, suppose that AB is an arc, makes an angle O at the center. So, angle made by the arc at the center, suppose that angle 1 is that, angle 1 is double, so double. The angle subtended by it, it means the same arc, it means the same arc. Angle subtended by it, angle subtended by it means the same arc. At any point on the remaining part of the circle, it means the angle, suppose that AB is an arc, makes an angle at the center, that is angle 1. Angle 1 is double the angle subtended by the same arc at the remaining part of the arc. What is the remaining part of the arc? That is a major arc. So that is angle 2. So angle 1 is double of angle 2. If you suppose that the angle is here, this is angle 3. So I can say that angle 1 is double of angle 3. Suppose the angle is here, a little bit up. So this is angle 4. Then again the angle 1 equals to double of angle 4, because angle 4 is in the major arc, not a part of the given arc. That's make angle. Okay. Now, suppose that the angle is going to make by the major arc. Now the major arc makes an angle at the center. So major arc makes that angle at the center on that side, the upper side. So now the angle made by the major arc of the remaining part is this one. So this is angle 1, this is angle 2. Now I can say that angle 1 equals to double of angle 2. Now how can I remember this? There is a very simple way, students. See, just a shortcut, we can say that. Not a shortcut, just a reminder part. This arc is the upward arc. This arc is also the upward arc. Like this. This is also upward arc. This is also upward arc. This is also like upward arc. So we can say that the smiley faces are same. This is also a smiley face. This is also a smiley face. Now in this, this is a sad face. This is a sad face. You understand my point? Then in this way you can recognize that the center is double of which arc. Suppose that if you make like that angle, the arc made by the smaller arc, the angle made by the smaller arc at a center, obviously this one, and second angle is this one, obviously both are opposite. This is smiley face, this is sad face. It means they are not the double of each other. They are not the double of each other. Means the arcs are same in the upward direction or the downward direction. Then we can say that the arcs are double to each other. In 95% question, this method will work, students. In 95% questions, this concept will work. Okay? Clear, everyone? The angles theorem? Now, yes?
Sir, can you please explain again, sir, when the major arc angle is given?
Sir, when the major arc is given, then angle at the center on that side, that is angle 1. So question is that the angle made by the major arc, now I am going to ask the major arc, use the major arc. The angle made by the major arc at the center is double the angle made by the same major arc on the remaining part of the circle. What is the remaining part of the circle? Minor arc now. So angle is 2, double of angle 2. Clear? Okay, now come to the theorem. Now student, first of all, this angle is 1, this angle is 2, this angle is 3. OB and OA are the radius. OB and OA are the radius of the same circle. If they are the radius of the same circle, then in triangle AOB, their opposite side angles are also equal. Angle opposite to the equal sides are equal. So I can say that angle 2 equals to angle 3. Similarly, OA and OC are equal. So angle 4 and 5 are equal. With the same method, with the same theorem, angle opposite to the equal radius are equal. Angle 4 equals to angle 5. Now, in triangle AOB. In triangle AOB. AOB. Here is angle 2. Here is angle 3. Here is angle 1. This one left hand side triangle. Exterior angle property. Angle 1 equals to angle sum of angle 2 plus 3. Angle 1 equals to angle 2 plus angle 3. Exterior angle property of triangle. 2 and 3 are equals to each other. We have already proved here. So I can write it like double of angle 1 equals to double of angle 2, because both are equals to each other. So I can write here double of angle 2. That's equation number 1. Now, same property, the same exterior angle property you have to apply on that side. Suppose that here is angle 6. So angle 6 equals to angle 4 plus 5. Same exterior angle property I will apply on the right hand side. So angle 6 equals to angle 4 plus angle 5. Now 4 and 5 again equals to each other. So angle 6 equals to double of angle 4. I have converted the angle 3 into angle 2 and angle 5 into angle 4. Because I need the angle on the circle. Note here, I need an angle on the circle. So, now join both the equations. Add both the equations. Angle 1 plus angle 6. Angle 1 plus angle 6 equals to double of angle 2, double of angle 4. Take the two common from both. Either you write first, then take the two common. I have done both the steps in one step. Take the two common. Both are going to add each other. Right hand side is added to right hand side. Left hand side is added to left hand side. After adding the right hand side, I have take the two common from that. Now angle 1 plus 6. Suppose that angle 1 plus 6, it becomes BOC. Obviously angle 1 plus 6 is BOC. So angle BOC equals to, what is this double as it is? What is 2 plus 4? 2 plus 4 is BAC. Hence prove that the angle made by the arc BC, suppose that BC is an arc, here is a point X, BXC, it represents the minor arc, BXC, it represents the minor arc. Suppose that the angle made by the minor arc at the center is double the angle made by the minor arc on the remaining part of the circle, that is major arc. Clear everyone? Okay,
yes, sir.
Now come to the next question. Next theorem, students. Angle in a same segment of the circle. Angle in the same segment of the circle means, in a circle, suppose that AB is the segment, AB is the line segment, and the up one is the major segment, lower one is the minor segment. They said that the angle in the same segment, the question is that theorem is that angle in the same segment. They are talking about the angle in the same segment. It means when the angle made in the, all the angles made in the major segment on the circle. All the angles made in the major segment on the circle, suppose that this is angle 1, this is angle 2, this is angle 3, this is angle 4. All the angles are equals to each other. All the angles are equals to each other. Clear? Then, suppose that another circle is there. Now, all angles are constructed in minor segment. Then, suppose the angle 2, angle 1. So, angle 1 equals to angle 2. Clear? So, the angle made in the same segments are equals to each other. Now, the next theorem. Angle in a semicircle. Angle in a semicircle is a right angle. Means, whenever the chord works as a diameter. Obviously, remember one thing. Whenever the chord works as a diameter, then there is no major arc, no minor arc, no major segment, no minor segment. It will work as a semicircle. There is a one Phillips also. Whenever the diameter works as a chord, it is called a semicircle. Then, the angle made by this chord, the angle made by the diameter on the circle, either in the upper part, either in the lower part, at anywhere in the circle, it's always a 90 degree. Clear everyone? Whenever the chord works as a diameter, the angle made by that chord or that diameter on the circle is 90 degree. Students, clear? Okay. So, this theorem is not in your syllabus. 10.5 and 10.10. I have already told you these two theorems are not in your syllabus. 10.5 and 10.2. 10.5 is on the 175 number page. And 10.10 theorem is on the 181 page. Okay, now the last one, this theorem. This is a very important theorem, students. When a cyclic quadrilateral is given, whenever it is given that cyclic quadrilateral is there, then it doesn't mean that the cyclic quadrilateral is always in the circle. No. The diagram can be made like that. Cyclic quadrilateral can also be including only the quadrilateral. It doesn't mean that whenever the cyclic quadrilateral word is there, the quadrilateral should be in the circle. No. Okay? It's a simple. Suppose that A, B, C, D quadrilateral is here. A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. They said that this is a cyclic quadrilateral. Yes, this can also be a cyclic quadrilateral. It doesn't mean that the quadrilateral always in the circle is a cyclic quadrilateral. The quadrilateral without a circle is also a cyclic quadrilateral. It depends upon the conditions. Now, whenever it is given that quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral, then their opposite, some of their opposite angles are always 180 degree. It means angle A plus C, angle A plus C is 180 degree, angle B plus D is 180 degree. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Example. This is a very important example, students, so listen carefully. Student, again I am not going to solve here the full question. full diagram. Sorry, I am not going to construct here the full diagram. I will construct the diagram as we solve the question. Now, first of all, O is the center of the circle. AB is the diameter of the circle. So, AB is the diameter of the circle. Even the AB is also works as a chord. Now, read the example with me. Example third. Yes, AB is the diameter of the circle, CD is a chord, CD is a chord, okay, we will join that, CD is a chord equals to the radius, it means the CD chord, given that CD chord is equal to the radius, OA and OB works as a radius. OA and OB works as a radius, so I can say that OA equals to OB equals to CD, because it is given in the question CD works as a radius, distance is equals to radius. Then AC and BD when extended intersect each other at point E, prove that AEB is 60 degree. We have to prove that angle 1, suppose that this is angle 1, angle 1 equals to 60 degree, we have to prove that angle 1 equals to 60 degree. Now how to prove this to them? First, yes, now first of all students, join the CB line, the CB line, that's the construction. First of all join the CB line. Now student, AB works as a chord and AB is a diameter, so angle in a semicircle makes angle 90 degree. Angle in a semicircle is a right angle triangle. Now I have told this theorem. Whenever the chord works as a diameter, then the angle made by that diameter on the circle is 90 degree. If this is 90 degree, then by linear pair property, this angle is also 90 degree. Clear everyone? Now the second, yes, now the second diagram, the same. Now join OD, OC and this. Now OC is a radius, OD is also a radius, and CD, it is given in the question that is a radius. It means all the three sides are equal. All the three sides are equal. It means OCD is a equilateral triangle. If it is a equilateral triangle, suppose that there is angle 2, so I can say that angle 2 equals to 60 degree, because angle of equilateral triangle are all are 60 degree. Everyone clear till now?
Yes.
Now the third step with a separate diagram.
Yes.
Again, I am not going to construct each and every line. I am only going to construct that line which I need only. That is a CD arc. Now I need a CD arc only. Now CD arc makes angle O at the center. That's given 60 degree. That's, we have proved 60 degree. Now join CB. Now check student, it's a very clear diagram. The CD arc, suppose that the CD arc makes an angle at the center 60 degree. CD arc makes the angle at the center CD, that angle is 2. Suppose that this angle is 3. So the angle at the center is double the angle subtended by the same arc CD at the circle. So what is angle 2? 60 degree equals to 2 angle 3. What is angle 3? Angle 3 equals to 60 half, that is 30 degree. So it means here the angle is 30 degree. It means this angle is 30 degree. Clear everyone? Everyone clear? Okay, now students, in CEB triangle, in CEB triangle, we have already proved that this is 90 degree, this is 30 degree. So by applying angle sum property on this triangle CEB, 90 plus 30, 120 degree. So 180 minus 120, it means this angle is 60 degree. Clear everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Example 4. In the figure, ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, we will solve this question from here. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. In which AC and BD are its two diagonals. AC and BD are its two diagonals. DBC is 50 degree, 55 degree. DBC means angle 1 is 55 degree. BAC is 45 degree. BAC is 45 degree. Find the angle BCD. Find the angle BCD. BCD. It means we have to find the full angle 4. Now how to find this angle? That's very easy, students. BC arc. The arc BC. The arc BC makes an angle A on the circle.